Okay, hi everyone. Today, in this video, I'm going to present about my research. The title is Spatial Autocorrelation Using Moran's Index to Map the Confirmed Positive of COVID-19 Cases in Java. Created by me, myself, my name is Nur Ainun Miftahul Huda, and my partner is Nur Fitri Imro'a and Rika Mailanda. In the 7th International Conference on Basic Science 2021, ICBS 2021, November 23, 2021. Okay, hi everyone. In this video, I will present about my research with my partner. The title is Spatial Autocorrelation Using Moran's Index to Map the Confirmed Positive of COVID-19 Cases in Java. Created by me, myself, my name is Nur Ainul Miftahul Huda, and then Nur Fitri Imro'a and Rika Mailanda. In the 7th International Conference on Basic Science 2021, ICBS 2021, November 23, 2021. Okay, this is the abstract of our research. The keywords is about, we talk about Moran's index and then spatial autocorrelation, and also about the COVID-19, especially in Java Island. So this is the outline. There are four outlines. The first one is introduction, and then method, data analysis, and the last is conclusions. So this is the introduction of our research. We talk about the spatial autocorrelation, which spatial autocorrelation is a fundamental concept in spatial analysis. So we talk about spatial analysis. So many researchers already done doing research on spatial autocorrelation. You can read on this slide. Okay, this is the visualization about what we already currently facing globally for almost 2 years, that is COVID-19 pandemic. So the movement of people is the key to spread of the COVID-19 virus. Earlier in the pandemic, every country had begun to implement policies to limit the movement of people from one area to another. As we know that COVID-19 firstly found in Wuhan, China, and then until now already spread to almost all of the country in the world. So one of these policies that has implemented by the government in every country is limiting the movement of people from one area to another. One of these policies is known as the lockdown. Countries in Europe mainly enforce this policy by closing entry and exit access. We know that United States, India, and then Brazil are the top three country with the highest most COVID-19 cases. So not much different from other countries. Indonesia also affected by COVID-19 cases, and Indonesia also applies restriction on human movement. So many policies that implemented by the government to decrease the number of COVID-19 cases. Java Island is the one of the island that has the highest number of infected COVID-19 cases. We know that Jakarta, West Java, and Central Java are the top three provinces with the highest number of COVID-19 cases. So why we choose Java? In this research, we use Java as the object in our research. And why we use Java? We choose Java because the high mobility between provinces in Java is also one of the factors for the increase in COVID-19 cases. Therefore, this study aims to find out how big the spatial correlation between location with several policies that the government has implemented, and the second aims is to map the spread of COVID-19 cases in Java Island based on the calculation of the Moran index. So we move on to the method. The next section is method. There are three subsections. The first one is wake matrix, Moran index, and Moran scatter plot. So wake matrix that we use in this research is inverse distance wake. So the principle of the calculation in this wake matrix is based on the actual distance between locations. So we can compute the wake matrix based on this formula, as you can see in the screen. And then the second subsection is Moran's index. So Moran's index is a correlation coefficient that measures the total spatial autocorrelation of the data set. So the value of Moran index is between minus 1 to 1, and the formula is as you can see in the screen. And then after we compute the Moran's index, we will make as a plot in Moran's scatter plot. So Moran's scatter plot is one way to interpret Moran index statistics. There are four quadrants in Moran scatter plot: first quadrant, second quadrant, fourth quadrant, and third quadrant. The first quadrant, located at the top right, is called high or HH, indicating an area with a high observation value surrounded by an area with a high observation value. The second quadrant, located at the top left, is called low high or LH, indicating an area with low observations but surrounded by areas with high observed value. So low observation surrounded by high observed value. The third quadrant, located at the bottom left, is called low, indicating an area with low observation values and surrounded by areas with low observation value. So low area and then surrounded by low observation value. And then the last quadrant is the fourth quadrant, located at the bottom right, is called high-low or HL, indicating an area with high observed value surrounded by an area with high area too. So at the end of the research, we will plot which one is the first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, or fourth quadrant. We move on to the data analysis. The data used is secondary data, namely data confirmed positive COVID-19 cases from January 11 until October 31, 2021. The data process is not daily cases observations, but first the data is partitioned based on the policy set by the government. This policy includes the large scale social restriction known as PSBB, restriction on community activities known as PPKM, emergency micro PPKM, first until fourth PPKM level, extension of each of these policies. So from January 11 until October 31, there were 26 partition based on the enforced policy. You can see in this table. So descriptive statistics of each location and all size were also considered in this table. You can see that Jakarta is the province with the highest COVID-19 cases, while Banten and Yogyakarta are the two provinces with the lowest infected COVID-19 cases. So this figure shows a plot of the average positive confirmed cases of COVID-19 per location by period based on government policy partitions. We can see that DKI Jakarta showed an increase in positive COVID cases, namely in the 14th partition. Okay, and at the 14th partition, at that time, the government immediately implemented the implementation of the emergency micro PPKM policy. Furthermore, the average number of cases began to decline at the exact locations, namely since the 19 partition, the PPKM level 3 policy was set. So the peak spike in cases for each location, for Jakarta, West Java, East Java, Central Java, Banten, and Yogyakarta, were in almost at the same partition, around 13 until 15 partitions. So a complete plot of each location you can see in this figure on your screen. So the most important thing from calculating the spatial autocorrelation using Moran index is the calculation of the spatial weight. As I said that before, we use in inverse distance weight matrix. So in this study, the distance in kilometer between province was measured from the provincial capital using Google Maps. You can see the result in this table. And then the weight matrix used is the inverse distance weight matrix based on the actual distance on the map. Okay. The next step, after we get the weight matrix, the next step is to calculate the Moran index for each observations, as you can see in this table. For example, the structural correlation in second partition is 0.584. It means the positive confirmed correlation of COVID-19 between province in Java is 58.4% when implementing the policy in second partition, namely the PPKM extension period, while the highest spatial correlation occurred at 26 partition, which was 0.998. The correlation was seen in all province experiencing a decrease in positive confirmed cases of COVID-19. This means that the policy implemented by the government have an impact on COVID-19 cases globally. Okay, after obtaining Moran's index, the next step is to make Moran scatter plot based on the result of the Z test using the Moran index test statistic. This scatter plot is then considered to determine which province are included in the high first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, or fourth quadrant categories. So using our software, Moran scatter plot is obtained as this figure. This is just an example for second partition and 26 partitions. So based on quadrant result, based on the scatter plot, Moran scatter plot, a mapping based on the quadrant level was made to a map of the province on the island of Java. The map is used to visualize the spatial influence of government policy on the behavior of positive confirmed cases of COVID-19. So this figure shows a map of the spatial correlation in Java on partition with a correlation of more than 50%. So based on this table, we can see which partition which has correlation more than 50%. There are 12 partitions. So for example, the interpretation is, if we see Banten province at the beginning of policy stipulations was in the LH quadrant. LH is blue, the color is of LH is blue, low high. Namely, Banten was in province with a low category, but located around a province with high category of cases, that there are Jakarta and West Java. Banten has also been in high category in the HH category, namely at 6 partition. This means that case experienced a spike followed by the surrounding province, namely DKI Jakarta and West Java, which also had high positive confirmed cases. However, this condition then began to change, namely in 12 partitions, Banten province was back in the LH quadrant. So interpretation for other provinces also follow depending on the color given. You can see the color on the top right on your screen. So the conclusion of our research is the province in Java Island have a high spatial autocorrelation seen from the Moran index value of more than 50% for 12 policies implemented by the government. The highest correlation is 0.998, which occurs in implementing the PPKM level 2 extensions policy from October 19 until November 1st, 2021. This means that globally, the policy has an impact on the province in Java. The mapping of the movement of COVID-19 cases in Java can also be seen from Moran scatter plot, which maps out which provinces are classified as high, low, and high-low levels. In Jakarta is mainly the high and high-low levels, but also experience a decline in cases and move to the LH level. While the province of East Java was initially at the low level, in current policy, it has moved to the high-low level. The level shift in province is very dependent on the COVID-19 cases and in the surrounding province. Okay, that's all for my presentation. Thank you. And if you have any question, you can kindly contact me in email or in WhatsApp. Thank you.